A common exercise that you'll see a lot of times when you're first learning about expressions and variables is they'll ask you to evaluate a certain variable expression. So like in this example, we have an expression 3x squared minus 40. And what they're going to ask us to do is evaluate this expression when x is a particular number, in this case, negative 5. So these are pretty straightforward to do. All you do is you go find your x and you take your x out and you replace it with whatever number they tell you to. The thing you have to be careful about is order of operations and signs, positive or negative, and being careful with things like that. So here, what I usually do is if I'm evaluating an expression, then I'll rewrite the expression, but anywhere that I had a variable, before I start plugging anything in, I'm gonna leave a blank. So 3 blank squared minus 40, because this used to be 3x squared minus 40. Everywhere that you had a variable, we're just going to pluck it out and leave parentheses here. And then whatever they want me to evaluate x as, then I'll plug in that number for x. So in this case, I'll take negative 5 and I'll plug it in where I had an x. And then I'll just compute this number here, being careful with order of operations. So I've got parentheses, and then exponents, and then multiplication, division, then addition, subtraction. I'm doing, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, the order of operations. So negative 5 squared is 25, so I have 3 times 25 minus 40. Next up comes multiplication. 3 times 25 is 75 minus 40. And last step, 75 minus 40 makes 35. So this is a particular variable expression evaluated when x was negative 5. Let's look at one more example. Let's say we've got a large variable expression with multiple variables. We're going to evaluate this expression when a is 4, b is negative 2, and c is 5. So basically, this is just plug and chug. We take these numbers, the 4, the negative 2, and the 5, and we'll plug them in for A, B, and C. So let's see if we can do that. We would have 2 parentheses, 2 times 4, that's 2 times A, minus C, that's minus 5, minus 5 times B, but B is negative 2. Okay, order of operations, say do the parentheses first. The negative 2 is finished. So next up, I'll compute this number here. 2 times 4 minus 5, multiplication comes first. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 minus 5 makes 3. And then again, minus 5 times negative 2. Okay, parentheses have been done. Now how about multiplication? 2 times 3 is 6. Negative 5 times negative 2 makes positive 10. So I have plus 10 instead of minus negative 10. And lastly, 6 plus 10 makes 16. So when you're evaluating a variable expression, as long as you're plugging in a numerical value, your answer should be a numerical value. So anyways, that's how we evaluate variable expressions.